Sicilites live by a code of chivalry, their hearts pure and noble.
But their greatest foe was Arthur's own half-sister, Morgana.
Convinced she was the rightful heir and desperate to possess Excalibur, she turned to dark sorcery.
Arthur fought a fearsome battle against her and bound her into the bowels of the earth.
But not before she swore dark vengeance.
When you are long gone, when hearts are hollow and the land is lost and leaderless again, I will return.
And so will the sword.
Alex! truth would just make everything worse. How could telling the truth make everything worse? You wouldn't understand. Dad would understand. Well, he's not here. But if he was, I know exactly what he'd say. He'd say that telling the truth and doing the right thing never makes anything worse. You always used to believe that, Alex. Yeah. Well, not anymore.
Go! We're right behind you!
Don't know, you little snitch!
experiment. Might be the way it comes. Look. A song written in the God. Put it into Google Translate. Gladius. Arturi. Filius. Tintagelli. It's Latin. It means sword of Arthur, son of Tintagel. Who's Tintagel? What are you doing? My dad gave me footballs years ago. About the Knights of the Round Table. I used to know off by heart. It's not Tintagel, it's Tintagel. And Tintagel's not a person, it's a place. An island off the coast of Cornwall. There's an old ruined castle there. Some people say it's where King Arthur was born. I went there once, when I was 5. It's where my dad lived. The last time I ever saw him. It's where I was when he gave me this book. He even signed it. Look. To Alex, my once and future king, Dad. Alex, what if this is a message? What if you're the only person who could have pulled that sword out? What if it's... Come on, but you'll laugh at me. I won't, I promise. What if it's the sword in the stone? Closest and oldest and very best friend. I knight thee. So, Bedisphere.
To include clothing in my vivifica transubstantiatio. Do you by any chance have any beetle blood, ground animal bone, or beaver urine? Very well. In that case, I require your smock. Surely, officers, it's not against the law to take a morning constitutional. Or to wear loose-fitting garments that permit fresh air to circulate around one's crevices and furrows. Now, your carriage seems warm and dry. Take me east, at once. Post haste.
Pay attention, everybody! We have a new pupil joining the class today. Why don't you introduce yourself?
Greetings, young academicians. My name is Mertin. Yes, that's right. Mertin Ambrosius Caledonensis. And I am a perfectly normal contemporary British schoolboy.
School who's more bullyable than us. We have to stay away from him as far away. away as possible.
Some metals are common, like copper, and are called base metals. Others are rare and valuable, like gold, and are called precious metals. Now, a long time ago, people called alchemists believed you could change base metals to precious metals.
These sections of the Earth's crust contain a wealth of history, ruins, dead bodies, evidence of past civilization.
You slowly move your moons across between the two. We'll start to see how these two planets, when their orbits intersect, will cause the upcoming total solar eclipse.
Upcoming? What do you mean, upcoming? When exactly is this total solar eclipse due?
4 days' time.
4 days? God sakes! This is a catastrophe! A disaster! I thought it was 4 years! Get out of my way! The dual realms will be bridged, and Morgana will return. Oh, no. You must saddle your steeds. Go.
Excalibur. Tell me the truth. Where did you get that thing?
I told you. On a building site.
Well, then we're taking it back there right now.
No! You can't take it away.
And you can't keep it. Alex, it's a dangerous weapon, and it doesn't belong to you.
Yes, it does. I pulled it out of a stone, and something came and tried to take it back. Something old and evil that came out of the ground. And a boy from school came, and he saved me. And then he turned into an owl. And I was wide awake the whole time, I promise.
Did you get that out of the attic? Alex, I know you're having a tough time. And I know you miss your dad. But he gave you that book because he wanted you to grow up to be a good person. Not the kind of person who gets into fights. Not the kind of person who believes in fairy tales. And not the kind of person who carries giant medieval weapons around.
Why did he write this?
Because he loved you.
Why did he leave?
Maybe I haven't told you as much as I should about him. He had his battles. His demons. But he loved you. And this has to stop. Now we're taking that sword to the police station and then I'm taking you to school. Alex, put that down, now.
No, it's mine. I need it.
I'm not telling you again.
I have to go. I'm taking it with me.
Alexander Elliot, don't you dare leave this house. Alex.
Sorry, Mom.
Solar eclipse.
That was exhausting. If I have to transform into my adult self every time I need to drive a point home, I'll be dead before the day is done.
Thank you. stupid to treat syphilis in the first place. You're coming back to my house, and you're not leaving until you explain exactly what just happened. Now, rewind. First, you want me not to smash your faces in?
Yes, please.
Then, you want us to skip school tomorrow morning, go to Cornwall with this freak new boy, find your long-lost dad, kill some demon sorceress, and save Britain from slavery.
Yes.
And out of all the people in the entire world, even though there's already a royal family, you're actually the real true king.
Trust me, I'm as shocked as you.
Well, there's one thing I don't get. Why would people like us help people like you?
Yeah. Why would we, like, even be seen with you? Because you're the strongest people I know. In the heat of battle, we had each other's backs. We just saved each other's lives without even thinking about it. That's exactly what King Arthur did. He made his enemies his allies. He united the warring tribes of Britain and formed a band of loyal knights. And together, they defeated an enemy bigger than all of them. And think about it. King Arthur's most loyal knight, called Lancelot, Kay, and Bedivere.
So?
So that's your names.
Oh my god. He's right.
The legend says Arthur's knights gathered at a round table so that they were all equal. And look. Quick, Bennett, lift up the flaps. See? None of this happened by accident. This is destiny. This was meant to be.
So they think themselves knights. How deluded they are. The boy Bedivere is meek. Nothing without his friend. The boy Lance is greedy. He plans to take the sword for himself. The girl Kay is clever but callow. Beholden to the boy. Himself. He clings to myth, trusts in lies. I will prey on their weaknesses. Their faith will crumble. Their hope will turn to hate. Their quest will be their doom.
Alexander, you've survived the night unscathed, emerged with two new allies, and formulated an excellent plan. To journey to Tintagel, find your long-lost father, who will then help you find the entrance to the underworld and destroy Morgana.
You think it's an excellent plan? Really?
Of course it is. Tintagel Island is King Arthur's birthplace. It is strong in magic. Mortes Millers cannot touch you there.
Sir Lance, Lady Kay, a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Do us a favor, Merton. Don't talk to us. We're only here for the fights.
That's hardly the attitude of a knight, young man. Where's your respect for the chivalric code?
Don't tell me you've never heard of the chivalric code.
Driver! Stop this coach at once!
The code is the cornerstone of a civilized society. The very credo upon which this nation was built. If you don't know the code, then this entire enterprise is utterly hopeless.
What the hell is he on about?
Excuse me, but why are we getting off the coach?
Shortcut. Follow me. Quickly. No slacking. Halt! Now, pay close attention. The chivalric code is the set of rules by which all noble knights live. Obeying the code from the moment the sword is drawn is what makes you pure of heart. And only a knight of pure heart can slay Morgana. You must commit the following to memory. Rule 1. Honor those you love.
Easy.
Yeah, I guess
refrain from wanton offense.
What? Wanton?
It's Chinese food, I think.
It is not Chinese food. Wanton means deliberate or unprovoked.
It means don't be rude or swear or be nasty to people.
All right, don't look at me.
Rule three, speak the truth at all times.
Easy, again.
That's a lie.
And finally, rule four, persevere in any enterprise until the end. Break any of these rules from the moment the sword was drawn, and your quest is lost before it has even begun. I trust that is not a problem.
Oi! Mini Merlin! What are you doing? We're not walking to Cornwall!
Indeed, we are not.
And for centuries, historians have puzzled over the purpose of Stonehenge. Was it a temple, burial ground, some sort of astrological clock?
No, it is not, you ignorant buffoon. Stonehenge is a transport hub. And just because the Romans knocked halfway down does not mean it's broken.
Excuse me? The general public's not permitted to approach the stones without the correct authorization.
Question.
both are. But why wouldn't we be? That is how the world works. Nothing you or anyone does is ever going to change that. I'm sorry we picked on you. I'm sorry he broke the sword. But we're not knights. We never were and we never will be. You're better off without us. No. You're wrong. We can't do this without you. You're Sir Lancelot and Lady Kay. We need you. It's too late. No, it's not.
Try!
mum even know you're here?
Right, then we have to call her.
No, this has nothing to do with her. Please don't. This is something I have to do on my own.
What did your mum tell you about him?
She said they were too young when they had me. He had other things going on in his life. She said he was battling demons. I didn't know what she meant. But I do now.
You do?
It's okay. You don't have to lie to me. I know who he really was.
Then why would you want to find him?
What do you mean?
He drank. He was angry at everything and everyone. He wasn't a good man, Alex. He lived here for a while, years back. That's when your mum brought you to see him. She thought he might have changed, but he hadn't. I don't even know where he is anymore. Like you said, he had his demons.
But I meant real demons. Magical demons. Like King Arthur. Like in the book he gave me. You don't understand. I'm the once and future king. And he knew. He wrote me this message. And he's waiting for me.
But Alex, your mum bought you this book. This is her writing.
Thank you.
sets. And if you do not defeat her, then it sets for the last time. For tomorrow the moon masks the sun and all is lost. This battle is yours, not mine. Journey with care. Be brave, chivalrous, and remember the code.
Thank you.
swarming defenses.
A fortress. A castle. The Mortes Miles will rise from the land across the roadway. They'll attack head on in a great and terrible multitude.
The eclipse gives us one advantage. It's not night or day. So this time, Merlin can fight beside us. But the five of us won't stand a chance on our own. We need to raise an army.
I'm relying on you three to set a good example. So when the entire school's out in the playground watching the eclipse, everyone behaves themselves. Is that clear?
Yes. Yep.
Why are all these children walking towards us? And what on earth are you children doing? Turning up to school in the middle of the morning, dressed like that?
Saving Britain from eternal slavery by an ancient undead evil wiz. Good. Take a sword.
To the barricades!
Trap her. Give me time to open a portal. Create a vortex. Then you must destroy her, so that she can never return.